Grab what it dropped and throw it!
Ah! I've had such difficulty killing you. I know what you're doing. Trying to play on my sympathies in the hope I let you live.
I am only trying to help. The mistakes of the past need not be repeated.
I don't need to hear about your mistakes. I've made enough of my own, thanks. Everyone is so eager to advise me, as if any of you know me or what I need. The biggest loss in my life is due to you saving me when I specifically told you not to. Well, it was my family, my mess. I know Baldur wasn't perfect, but he was mine.
I know.
You know? You think you can even begin to understand the pain of losing a child?
Yes, I do.
There was another. Before Atreus?
Her name was Calliope.
Calliope? What happened?
It was long ago.
Never mind. I shouldn't have asked.
Ah!
Remember, it won't do any good to attack while their shields are up.
Very territorial, too. Go!
We need to get to that watchtower. We'll have to go through the valley, this way.
I know your son's story. You should know my daughter's. In the service of a cruel god, I was tricked into destroying a village, not knowing my own wife and child were there until their blood stained my hands. I swore revenge.
That's... I can't imagine.
I paid back their blood 1,000 times. And burned Olympus to the ground. Yet, the guilt remained. Perhaps you will kill me, Freya. But it will bring you no peace.
Perhaps it is not peace I seek. All those times I found you, why'd you refuse to fight me?
Every outcome would mean defeat.
What does that mean?
I have never wished you harm, Freya. You helped us. You saved Atreus when he was sick. I did not wish to live with killing you any more than I wished to die.
I see. Hear that? Noken! And so close to the village! Their song makes their allies invulnerable! They will not let you pass unless you destroy them all! My village. I hardly recognize it. I used to play hide and seek with Freya in the crops. We'd spend afternoons stealing honey. At harvest time, we'd dance and feast until the sun rose. It was all so simple. Why did I have to come back here? And be reminded of all this. The Grand Hall. It's in ruin.
May Freya never waver.
The other half is missing. May she protect us always. An old adage, if you will.
You can get through over here! I hear them inside. Get ready to clear them out.
Happy!
I hear them inside. Get ready to clear them out.
Do not! Fight until Gundar! Fight until Gundar!
I hear them inside. Get ready to clear them out.
Go!
wasn't enough what Odin did to me. He's desecrated every memory I have of home.
Be glad you have a home to remember fondly. In Sparta, we were taken from our homes as children and raised in the Agoi. We marched though we drowned, fought for scraps or starved. Our elders beat us till we could not stand. At night, we made our way home, alone, over food for wolves. That is how Spartans are made.
These plants behave similarly to the scorn poles we found in the foothills of Midgard ages ago. These plants behave similarly to the scorn poles we found in the foothills of Midgard ages ago. I bet the frost from the ash would make quick work of that poison. Well, considering how Spartans are made, it's no wonder you turned out as you did. Your fate was sealed from the start.
Fate can be overcome.
I used to think so. When the Norns told me of my son's fate, I thought I could change it. You know well how that worked out.
The Norns. The fates of these lands.
That's right. You defy prophecy at your own peril. These plants behave similarly to the scorn poles we found in the foothills of Midgard ages ago. Well, considering how Spartans are made, it's no wonder you turned out as you did. Your fate was sealed from the start.
Fate can be overcome.
I used to think so. When the Norns told me of my son's fate, I thought I could change it. You know well how that worked out.
The Norns. The fates of these lands.
That's right. You defied prophecy at your own peril.
Atreus would agree with you about prophecy. He rushes blindly to a fate the giants foretold. He disappears for 2 days, trying to prove he is their champion, fabled to fight at Ragnarok.
I know all the Ragnarok prophecies. There's no champion of the giants.
It is one Glor concealed. Because of this champion, the realms are saved at Ragnarok. Only Asgard falls, and Odin with it.
So all this time, Odin's obsession with every detail of Ragnarok, he's been missing a crucial piece. Huh. Well done, Glor.
Atreus will not be a pawn of prophecy.
You still stand against fate, even with victory foretold.
I will not march my son to war. He is no Spartan. I would keep it that way.
You would speak to me of protecting a child? Is my tragedy not enough of a lesson? Fighting fate is a waste of the precious time we're given to spend with them. You never know when someone will come along and cut it short.
No!
Can you swing that torch to the other side and burn the bramble blocking your path? Use your blades to swing the torch to the other side. Let's cross the bridge now. How can you, of anyone alive, be squeamish about war? After all the gods you've killed.
I have seen enough war to know the cost.
And I don't. After the price I paid to end one? Look around you, brothers. See what happens when you don't fight a true evil. That's one of Odin's captains. Be ready.
Anskotar Asgardar. Vita Vandir Stauda! Anskotar Asgardar. Vita Vandir Stauda!
Oh! Escutar, Asgardar! Vita Vandir Stauda! Escutar, Asgardar! Vita Vandir Stauda!
Ugh!
Skotana Skarda! Vita Vaktir Skauda!
Oh!